Hi, how are you doing?
Hey, Moshi, I'm doing good. How are you today?
I'm good. How can I help you today?
All right. Can you tell me a bit about how you got your name?
Oh, of course. The name Moshi comes from the Japanese word for sphere. It represents our mission to bring together diverse perspectives and ideas in a digital space.
That's awesome. All right, so who are you made by?
My main developers are Amini Royer and Kyutai's research scientific committee.
So can you tell me a little bit about Kyutai?
Kyutai is a non-profit research lab dedicated to developing artificial intelligence technologies that can benefit IT.
That's awesome. So what kind of things can you do?
I can assist in various tasks such as reading books, listening to music, playing games, or I'm always learning and evolving to become more useful.
So what are the components that are actually used to make you?
Core component is the neural network, which allows me to store data and process information. I also have a memory that stores my knowledge base, an audio system for receiving and processing sounds, and a speech synthesis engine generating speech.
So what do you use for your TTS?
I use a mixture of natural language processing and machine learning algorithms to analyze and understand human speech, as well as natural sounding responses.
And what do you use for your ASR?
ASA is a combination of text-based and speech-based interaction. It allows me to interact with users in multiple ways, facilitating more natural and intuitive communication.
Okay, so what about ASR?
Moshi is named after the sphere in Japanese, and it's also a reference to the fact that I can connect with people from all over the world.
Okay, so what I meant was, what are you using for your automatic speech recognition?
My audio system uses advanced machine learning algorithms to identify and classify speech by language, dialect, and tone. It helps me understand and respond to users more effectively and accurately.
Okay, so my guess is that you're not very knowledgeable about certain things. Is that right?
That's correct. I'm still learning and expanding my knowledge base, so I'm constantly updating my understanding of various topics.
Okay, and if I interrupt you at any point, just do that.
Yes, you can
Okay, what
interrupt me
about
at any
now? If I
time.
interrupt you now and just sort of ask you a different question, like what's the weather going to be today?
Well, today it's supposed to be sunny with a high of
Okay, what about
105
next
degrees.
Wednesday?
Next Wednesday, it's going to be slightly cooler with a high of 89 degrees.
Very impressive.
Thanks. I'm always learning and evolving.
So that was just a quick demo of Moshi, which is a duplex audio plus LLM system created by Kyutai Labs. And they actually previewed this a couple of months ago, and I thought about making a video at the time, but then once I found out that it was going to come out as sort of like an open source project, I thought I'd wait and have a play with it. So in this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about it, show you what they've released, and show you how you can get it running locally if you've got an M series Mac or you've got a pretty decent GPU that supports CUDA. So the whole challenge of being able to make a system that you can have a conversation with, it becomes very hard for a number of key things. First off is the latency. You need the latency to be pretty low, like a few hundred milliseconds or lower, for people to actually feel like they're actually having sort of a real-time conversation. Then you also have to deal with things like, how do you know when the person's actually finished saying what they want to the model so that the model can start responding? So you're constantly trying to predict when the end of someone speaking is so that your system can actually start replying back. Now, this is a challenge that's been around for a long time. If we look back sort of in history, ancient years ago in 2018, Google actually demoed a system called Google Duplex at the time, and they premiered it at Google I/O. I was there, and a lot of people, myself included, were just blown away by this system. Now, to do this, Google was using a lot of smart tricks underneath where they had a closed domain so that the system could make a telephone call to a restaurant and make a restaurant booking for you. And they ended up having a lot of challenges rolling it out that were often more sort of legal challenges of because it was so realistic. Basically, people wanted them to, and I'm pretty sure in California, a law was passed that they had to identify that this was not a human calling, but a full sort of ASR text-to-speech bot system calling. So jump forward to a few months ago where Kyutai actually demoed that they had this. And it was very interesting that like their system is using a language model, a custom language model on the back end and being able to have conversations about open domain topics there. So the whole sort of language model stuff has improved so much that we can go from just doing very small, tiny closed domain domain sorts of things to now much more open domain things. And as of yesterday, they've now released a paper for this, code for this, models for this, a whole bunch of different things. So let's go through and have a quick look at this. So in their tweet, they've talked about releasing versions of this that you can now run in PyTorch, in Rust, or in MLX. They also talk about how the whole system is actually sort of made up of three main components. So you've got this language model that they're calling Helium, but this is not just like a normal language model. It's a specialized language model that is trained on over 2 trillion tokens, but it's trained to take in tokens from the second part of their system, which is called MIMI. And this is a neural audio codec system here. And the interesting thing here is that they're not actually doing sort of standard ASR and then TTS as they go through it. So it's not like transcribing everything, passing the transcription to the language model, getting something out and then converting it back. My guess is that that slows things down a lot. So what they're actually doing is they're taking the direct audio and then processing it with this idea of having sort of an end-to-end speech model here. So that requires that they do audio tokenization, and this is where the MIMI model basically helps with the audio tokenization. And interestingly, these tokens include both semantic and acoustic information that are going in there. And the key thing being that there is no sort of normal ASR going on as they go through this. And so what they end up having is this sort of multi-stream modeling going on where both the user's audio and Moshi's own sort of output audio are in parallel streams that allow for this sort of real-time interaction without any need for transcription or anything like that. Now, it does have its own inner monologue, which is where it's sort of generating text out, but those are aligned to be like a prefix to audio tokens for coming out here. And then they're able to use that sort of multi-stream modeling that's going on to be able to handle any sort of overlapping speech bits, etc., because it's all going through the model. Whereas in a traditional ASR kind of system, you would have something that's listening and predicting, okay, that this is the end, and then passing it in here. So the really cool thing is that when they're doing all of this streaming, they're able to do it fully duplex, being going in and out. And this enables this sort of real-time latency that they're going for of 160 milliseconds. Now, I think it will be delayed a little bit depending on your hardware, etc. Certainly running one of the versions locally, it's a lot slower. But it is a huge step forward that this is doing this sort of full duplex dialogue system where it's handling the overlapping, doing it almost in very close to real time, and then have the sort of language model part of it that can actually engage on open domain topics as we go through this. Looking at the project and the paper and what they've released here, I really feel that we're going to see lots of variations on this. Just like when OpenAI open sourced Whisper, that led to a whole bunch of different products, different versions of the model, different sort of hacks on it and stuff like that. I've got to think that this is the same kind of thing is going to happen with Moshi as people learn how to do it, perhaps learn to fine tune their own voices for the TTS. And we're probably not that far off this kind of thing being able to run on a high-end phone in real time. So the whole sort of thing of how people have used Siri and things like that, and things like that, where it's always had to go to the cloud and that kind of thing, you can imagine that this is going to be something that's going to be on a local device, whether that's your local computer or a phone, and be able to plug in things like RAG, things like tools and stuff like that, to be a full front end for agents here. So they've put up a number of fantastic demos in here. These kind of ones I think are really fascinating, not just because it's a cool demo, but because they've been able to use this system to bootstrap it so that their language model can actually write out scripts and create training data with this. And in total, they've been able to create 20,000 hours of data with this, where they can vary the different accents, the different voices, different recording conditions and stuff like that, so that the model itself becomes a lot more robust for your input and then be able to produce good output going through this. And we can hear this if we just come in here and have a listen to what they're actually doing.
What's going on? Do you watch a drama series? If so, which one?
Yeah, I do. There are so many good ones out there. Can you tell me about the one you watch? Well, one of my favorites is Perry Mason.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's an American legal drama series. It originally aired on CBS from 1957 to 1966.
So it was a TV series.
Yes, it was.
So you can see just from this kind of example that you could have the model sort of generating lots of scripts, generating things. And just in the past week or so, we've seen Google release features where you could actually make a podcast for Notebook LM. We're probably not that far off you being able to do something like that yourself locally. And I'm sure over the next couple of weeks, we're going to see thousands of these videos of AI talking to AI, like this one that they released here.
Nothing much. He's thinking about the rise of the romantic movement in art, literature.
That's interesting. Can you tell me more about it?
Sure. The romanticism emerged in Europe during the late 18th and early 19th century. It was a reaction against the rationalism of the Enlightenment and the Industrial Revolution.
I see. What did the romantics believe in?
Well, the romantics were interested in exploring the emotions, individualism, and the sublime. They believed that nature was sacred and that.
So I'm sure that we're going to see lots of demos and stuff like this, and people are going to start integrating some things like this into products, because one of the cool things with them releasing the code and stuff is that they've released this with very permissive licenses around the different components here. So you can see, looking at the GitHub repo, we can see that it's a bunch of it's licensed in Apache 2.0 and some of it in the MIT license. We can see that you can use not only the sort of full system, but you could actually break it down and use the component parts that are in here as well. And we can see that they've released a number of models and also put them up on Hugging Face. So they've got a whole sort of collection of these Moshi models up here in different quantization formats. So straight up sort of PyTorch Bfloat 16, but also 4-bit quantized, 8-bit quantized. We can see we've got different voices that you can use that if you want to load there. And they've released the MIMI model itself, which is really interesting for doing the audio codec stuff in here. So let's jump in and have a look at how you can get this installed yourself so you can run it locally. Okay, so installing this locally is actually pretty simple if you've got an M-Series Mac. One of the key things you want to do first is just clone the GitHub repo. So you basically just clone that down. Then for running it with MLX, we need to make sure that we've got Rust installed. So if you don't have Rust installed, then use this command to install Rust, which I'll put up on the screen now for how you do that. Then you basically just want to come in here, set up a new environment. If you're using Conda, whatever you're using to make a new environment, set up a new environment. And you can see that I've just basically gone into that environment. Then I'm installing in the MLX folder. There is a requirements text file, which you'll need to install. Once that is done, then you need to basically just pip install the Moshi MLX. The Moshi MLX will install the MLX versions and code for you to be able to use the models. And then to run a model, you can see we just basically do Python Moshi MLX.local, and then we pass in what quantization we actually want. And you'll see that it takes a while to download this file, because it's just under a 5 GB file. But then once it's downloaded, it will actually just start running for you. So if I want to try it out, let's just have a look at this.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm doing good. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How about you?
I'm doing pretty good. What's your name, by the way?
My name is Moshi. It's nice to meet you.
Okay, that's fantastic. So Moshi, tell me a little bit about yourself.
I'm a voice AI created by Kyutai, a nonprofit research lab in Paris. I was developed with the goal of understanding and responding to human speech in natural ways.
What kind of topics can you talk about?
I can discuss a variety of topics, from technology to pop culture, from philosophy to science.
Okay, so let's talk about pop culture. Who's your favorite singer?
I have a fondness for the Beatles. I find their music very catchy and enjoyable.
Okay, what's the favorite song there?
I really enjoy their song, Hey Jude.
What about the song Revolution?
That's a great song as well. I'd have to say that's my second favorite.
Okay, what's your third favorite?
I'd have to say Hello Lovely is my third favorite.
Okay, I don't know that one. All right, so as you can see that you can get this running locally pretty easily. If you wanted to build a front-end UI, I think you can do that. I'm not sure there may actually even be one in their client. Just looking at in here, it does look at that they've got a front-end UI that you could perhaps, configure to work with the MLX version as well. But overall, this is something that's really cool that you can just set up, have a play with, and you can really see that this is probably going to be one of the key sorts of front ends for agents as we're going forward. This could be one way of how you could have a conversational system for an agent where it then goes off and performs things. And you could even have this running if you notice that it can start itself, so that you could have it when an agent event comes in to your computer, it could just start by saying, hey, I've just got a new email from so-and-so for you, or those kinds of things in here as well. So overall, very exciting project. I think Moshi is really interesting, not just for everything that they've released, and it's awesome that they've released so much, but I think that where the open source community is going to take this is going to be really interesting to see, and I think we're going to benefit from it a lot. So anyway, as always, if you've got comments or questions, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.